What's up, internet? I am Manish from rebellionrider.com and I'm back with another PLSQL tutorial, and most probably the last one in the series. So we have learned a lot about dynamic SQL, and it's time to move ahead to dynamic PLSQL. Yes, today's tutorial is about dynamic PLSQL. That means in this video we will be learning how to write a PLSQL block using execute immediate of dynamic SQL. So without further ado, let's start the tutorial. This demonstration will involve two PLSQL blocks, one which we will be running using execute immediate of dynamic SQL, and the other into which we will be writing execute immediate statement. Don't be confused, let's just start writing the code, as that will make things clearer. Let's first write the PLSQL block which we will be running using execute immediate statement. Here we have a simple yet complete PLSQL block. It has a declaration section as well as an execution section. In declaration section, we have declared only one variable, var_user of varchar2 data type. And in the execution section, we have only two executable statements. The first statement is a select into statement, which is returning and storing the current user through which we are connected to the database into our variable var_user. The second statement is a simple output statement, which is displaying back the username which the above select into statement stored into the variable var_user. In a nutshell, this PLSQL block on successful execution will show you the username using which you are connected to your database. This is nothing but a simple PLSQL block. Just remember one thing. Unlike SQL statement, here you are allowed to end your PLSQL block which you want to run with execute immediate statement with a semicolon, like this. But do not put the forward slash after your PLSQL block, which we are used to doing. Now we want to run this PLSQL block using dynamic SQL. Let's see what is the proper way of running a PLSQL block using dynamic SQL in Oracle database. So first let's open a fresh worksheet. Here we go. Now here we will write our main PLSQL block. Let's do that. This is the declaration section of our main PLSQL block. In this section, once again, we have declared only one variable, PLSQL_BLK. We will be using this variable for holding the PLSQL block, which we will be running with the execute immediate statement. As the execute immediate accepts only arguments of varchar2 type, thus we have declared PLSQL_BLK as varchar2 data type. Also, this variable will be used for holding the entire PLSQL block, thus it should have sufficient data width. Here in my case, I have set the data width to 200, which should be more than enough. If it isn't, then we will update it accordingly. Now let's move ahead. Now let's go to the previous worksheet and copy the PLSQL block which we just prepared to paste it here. Let's quickly fix the indentation so that this code will look less confusing. Now it's looking great. Next, we have to enclose this entire block into a pair of single quotes. Let's do that. Done. Now, end this assignment statement with a semicolon. Yes, unlike SQL statements with execute immediate, where we only have semicolons outside the single quotes, here we have semicolons before and after the closing single quotes. That's the main difference which you have to take care of. Before moving ahead, we need to fix a simple problem. As you can see, the single quotes of the string which is inside the output statement is causing a conflict with the single quotes of our assignment statement. So, how can we fix it? We can easily fix this conflict by enclosing the string of the output statement into double single quotes. Mind here, it's not double quotes, it's double single quotes, like this. That's it. This completes the assignment operation where we assigned a PLSQL block into a variable. Now we will use this variable with execute immediate statement of dynamic SQL, which will be the next statement. Let's write that. That's it. Just write the result phrase execute immediate followed by the name of the variable into which you have stored your block and a semicolon at the end of the statement. This statement is going to be the last statement, thus now we will end this PLSQL block. This time you are free to put the forward slash here. Great, now let's execute and see the output. We got an error. Let's see what is it. Numeric or value error. Character string buffer too small. Okay, what does that mean? That means we need to increase this data width. Let's replace this 200 with 250. Now let's try to execute this program again. Here is our output. So the output is current user is HR. And that's how we run a PLSQL block using execute immediate of dynamic SQL. If you want to learn how to run a named PLSQL block such as PLSQL function with execute immediate, then visit the blog. I have put the link in the description. That's the last tutorial in the PLSQL series. If there is any topic which has slipped from my mind or anything you want to suggest, please comment and let me know. I will be more than happy to take your suggestions and create a tutorial on that. That being said, let's wind up this video. This is the tutorial on how to properly write a PLSQL block using execute immediate of dynamic SQL in Oracle database. It's more like dynamic PLSQL than dynamic SQL. Anyways, if you enjoyed watching, then give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends on your social media. Most importantly, don't forget to subscribe as we will soon be starting a new programming series for you. Thanks. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.